Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, please subscribe. Today I'm super excited because I'm doing a collaboration. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, please subscribe. I'm super excited. Today I'm doing a collaboration with Jessica from Keep Calm and Clean and Jessica from Jessica Ann Davis and Katie Satilli, which I think her last name is so fun to say. We are all doing some crock pot meals, which are awesome for mothers, but I actually fell in love with crock pot. So this is probably take 500. Toddler is off my lap. We now have my Yorkie Sean. This is Romeo. Hi, Rom. Anyway, so go follow Jessica, and Katie. All of their channels are amazing. I will leave their links to their channels in the description box below. They have things mommy related, motivational cleaning videos, basically anything lifestyle related, decor, more meals, recipes. Definitely check them out. So my meal that I'm going to be doing is a staple in our house. It is very versatile. The leftovers are delicious. I am such a leftover snob. I hate leftovers, but I will actually eat this meal for the rest of the week. So what I have is a delicious pulled chicken tacos. For this recipe, I am gluten-free, so I use all gluten-free products, but you could use flour tortillas or... I am newly postpartum. My baby is 3 months old, so I am trying to be extra healthy to get the extra baby weight off. This recipe is very health conscious friendly. It's low calorie, low fat, and it's delicious, which is the best part. And also my toddler loves it, so I will take that any day. You could put this on top of salads, you can just put it in a taco, have it over rice, however you want. It's very versatile. All you do is dump everything in the crock pot, and at the end you shred it. It's amazing. So let's just get to it, and make sure you go follow my friends Jessica, and Katie.
So here I just have some organic salsa, it's medium, black beans, corn with jalapeno. It really wasn't very spicy, it was perfect. And then just gluten-free taco seasoning. Put the chicken breast in, I then top it with the taco seasoning. Next I put the salsa in. This was a kind of a big jar, so I just used half, but use your own discretion. I just didn't want it to turn out watery. And then the jalapeno corn. Black beans. Kind of just, not even really stir, just kind of like move the stuff around so it's on top of each chicken breast. You could also use thighs for this recipe. I put mine on high for 3 hours because I was in a rush, but you could cook it on low for however long. And this was before we tried to make like a crunch wrap from Taco Bell. We just used some steam ready rice because we have no kitchen right now, so we need the microwave. And here's what my taco looks like. Soft shell on the outside, crunchy on the inside, and Carter loves it. He has some avocado with it. It was so delicious. You can also add some lettuce, tomato. These were my leftovers the next day. You can see it gets thicker the next day. This was after it was refrigerated for 24 hours.
So we hope that you love this video. I hope that you love everyone else's videos for their crock pot meals. Please subscribe if you're new to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up and let me know if you want to see more crock pot meals. I have a million because they are a staple in my house, with a 22-month-old and a 3-month-old.